I request you to take your seat on stage and meet the student panelists, Rishi, Srinandini, Arya, and Aman, who will be engaging you in an informative question and answer session. To get to know more about the great personality, over to Aman.
Thank you, Shalini. Good morning, ma'am. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our campus here. On behalf of the panelists, I would also like to mention what a privilege it is to be a part of this conversation with you here today.
Thank you.
To start off the session, we have the first question from a student at the GIIS Ahmedabad campus. Ma'am, we know that you attended the Delhi School of Music at the age of 12. Were you able to cope up with academics and music at such a young age?
For me, academics was a priority because my parents always thought that that studies are very important. And music, I was learning side by side. So my studies were never interrupted or disturbed. And even if I had to travel somewhere for a performance or something, I used to carry my books with me and I used to study while I was traveling. And I was very good at academics. I'm not lying.
Ma'am, being a music lover from your youth, who did you aspire to be like as a singer?
Well, the first name that comes to my mind is Jagjit Singh. He was a legend. I consider him a legend. I've grown up listening to his music, his ghazals, and I've learned so much just by listening to his music. The way he used to sing or approach a sentence or a line, the way he used to pronounce the words and his voice and the kind of music, how he touched millions of hearts, and especially his live concerts. I was a kid when I saw him perform live, and that day I decided that I want to do concerts like Jagjit Singh ji. I want to become like him.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm sure our students are inspired by motivation.
Thank you. Our next question comes from the GIIS Tokyo campus. Ma'am, you've previously sung the song Balle Balle for the Pakistani film Bin Roye, and the students would like you to share your experience.
Well, Balle Balle is a song from a film called Bin Roye, as you said, and because I couldn't go to Pakistan to record the song, Shiraz Uppal has given the music of the song. So we recorded it over Skype. See, we use technology in a great way. So he logged on to Skype and I was there in the studio with my headphones on. I had the track with me. He emailed me the track. So I was listening to the music and then he was on Skype directing me to how to sing the song and how he wanted the song to be. So then we recorded the song, we emailed him back and he really liked it. And then later it was shot on the beautiful Mahira Khan. So I didn't actually meet him to record the song.
Yes, ma'am. That's very interesting. If you don't mind, could you sing a few lines from the song for us?
Oh, I don't mind.
रात की रंगीनी देखो क्या रंग लाई है हाथों की मेहंदी भी देखो खिलखिलाई है बल्ले 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 सजे है ये बावरा जिया बल्ले बल्ले नाचे है ये बावरा पिया
Thank you for obliging to sing, ma'am. That was truly mesmerizing. I would like to add that Balle Balle is one of my favorite songs.
Thank you so much.
Ma'am, our next question comes from the GIIS Abu Dhabi campus. You wear so many different turbans for your performances. We would like to know who designs them and the brooches for you.
I would like to ask who designed these turbans today. Kya baat hai, taaliyan ho jaye, ma'am ke liye. Well, it's actually a very long cloth. Malmal ka kapda hai. It's around 4.5 meters. The same that my dad wears. So it's nothing permanent. He has to tie it every time I perform. So yes, he's the one who ties the turban on my head.
Ma'am, we've seen you wearing a turban at public events and at performances.
Ma'am, you also mentioned in one of your earlier interviews that the turban has become part of your identity. Is there any particular significance to it?
Well, it started off because of a reality show that I did. It was called Junoon Kuch Kar Dikhane Ka. It happened in 2008. And it was a competition amongst three different genres, which was Bollywood, Sufi, and folk. And I was in the Sufi team. And because I was singing Sufi songs every week, I wanted my head to be covered. So one option was to take a dupatta or a chunni. And then one day in our house, we were just having a discussion and we thought, why not try something else? So my sister's husband, he suggested, why don't you try a turban? And I was like, girls don't wear turbans. So he said, no, why not try it? So my dad offered, you can take my turban. So we just tried it out and I twisted it a little according to my face structure and it looked really nice on me. So on the day of the shooting, I wore a beautiful Sufi dress and I wore the white turban with it. And it looked really royal and really, really graceful. So it started off like that, with that reason that I wanted my head to be covered, but it slowly became a style statement. And now people identify me with the turban.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am. Next, we have a question from a student from GIIS Kuala Lumpur. Ma'am, you have already sung for most of the leading music directors in the industry. What do you want to see yourself as in another 20 years?
Another 20 years, I'll be 50. I don't know what I'll be doing, but hopefully I'll be happily singing songs only. And, you know, once you're into music, you always want to do that. Maybe an extension of my own singing. Maybe I'll be composing more and releasing more independent songs. Maybe I open a music school, I don't know. So nothing is planned. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow, so 20 years is too much.
Ma'am, that sure sounds interesting. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Ma'am, our next question is from our GIIS Bengaluru campus. You have sung so many devotional songs. Do you have any particular reason for it?
Well, devotional music is something that we learn at a very early age. So when our parents, in our growing age, they sing hymns to us, shabads or bhajans, so that, you know, the child is calm. And it's a bhajan or a devotional song is like your first introduction to music. So that's what happened to me. When I was really young, my mom used to sing a lot of shabads. And in school also, there's morning prayer. We begin the day with a prayer. So that's your first introduction to God or to spirituality. So that's why I was always inclined towards devotional music. And I have listened to a lot of Sufi music, which is also a form of devotional music. So that's my way of connecting to the Almighty. And I think everybody does that. People say that music is the strongest medium to connect to God. We're too young to talk about God, but eventually, how when you're studying for your exams, you're praying to God, Bhagwan mujhe achhe number de dena. You do that, right? So we remember Him only when we want something. We should actually remember Him all the time. And the best way to do is through music.
Ma'am, you work.
Clap for God.
You have worked in a Bollywood film, Rang De Basanti, where you sang Ik Onkar. What was it like singing a devotional song in a Bollywood film?
It was a great experience for me to sing something that I had been singing since childhood. Ik Onkar is from the Japji Sahib, and the part that I've sung for Rang De Basanti is the Mool Mantra. So that one small paragraph contains the entire meaning of being one to the God. Ek Onkar means His name is true, the true name. And to sing that for a legend like A.R. Rahman was a dream come true. I had always imagined just meeting him and just taking an autograph or just saying hello or taking a picture with him. But I never could have imagined in my dreams that I would get an opportunity to sing for him. So they narrated me the story of the movie and they said it'll be shot at the Golden Temple. At that time, I didn't know that it was going to be in the music album also as an individual song. So when I went to buy the CD, I saw the CD and I read my name on it. Track number one, Ek Onkar Harshdeep Kaur. So that feeling, just to read your name on a music album of a huge movie, music by a great music director, and something that you have been singing since childhood, it was a great feeling. And recording that for Reha Rehman was another feeling. And he was very kind to have made me feel very comfortable. He said, just close your eyes and just sing it 2-3 times. So he took the best take that I had given. So that's one of the most memorable moments in my life.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, having such an early start to your career and being an acclaimed artist at such a young age, we're curious to know, how did your interest in Sufi music develop?
Well, if you listen to my voice, it's not a typical female playback singer's voice. How Lata ji used to sing or Asha Bhosle ji used to sing. They had very high-pitched voice. But when I sing, my voice is quite low-pitched. I'm telling you the honest reason why I was inclined towards Sufi music. So I used to sing songs that suited my voice. Like I used to listen to Reshma ji, Jagjit Singh ji, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan sahab, because I could sing along with them while the CD or the track was playing. So that was one reason that I got inclined towards the music of Reshma ji, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan sahab. And Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan sahab sings a lot of qawwalis and devotional music and Sufi music. So that's how I got inclined towards it. And later, when I started understanding the meaning of those words, I loved them even more. So that's the main reason.
Thank you, ma'am. That's a wonderful story.
Our next question comes from our sister campus here in Singapore, GIIS Queenstown. Back in 2008, you were declared Sufi Ki Sultana by none other than Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. You were young at the time, so how did you feel when you received this title, ma'am?
I just wanted to hear my name in Amitabh Bachchan's voice. Harshdeep Kaur, Sufi Ki Sultana. So I think that was God answered my prayers, and yes, Amitabh Bachchan ji was the chief guest on the show and he announced my name. I was very happy. That's it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, our next question comes from our home campus, GIIS East Coast. In our school, GIIS EC, we organize the Global Indian Stars Singing Competition every year. In this competition, not only do students of GIIS campuses take part, but also all those living in Singapore who take an interest in singing. As a young singer and achiever, what is your advice to students who want to take up film singing as a career?
I think I spoke a lot over there. But if you want to take up music as a career, especially Bollywood, as you said, Bollywood film music as a career, you should shift to Mumbai. Yes, that's true. I'm from Delhi. I'm born and brought up in Delhi. But after I finished my school, we shifted to Mumbai because Mumbai is the hub for Bollywood music and movies. So everything takes place in Mumbai. All the music directors are there in Mumbai. So you should go and meet them. But if you can't, thanks to technology, you can always record your song on YouTube or anywhere and just email it to the music directors, or just open your own YouTube channel and start singing and you might get noticed. There have been success stories like these that you become popular on your social media, on your YouTube channel. If you're really good, your songs can get viral and then Bollywood will come to you to Singapore.
That's wonderful, ma'am. I'm sure in a few years, a lot of our students will be buying plane tickets to Mumbai. We also want to know, ma'am, is it easy getting a break in the Bollywood music industry? Do you have any tips for our students to get them on the path to success in this field?
Well, nothing is easy in life. Actually, there are certain things that are easy, but when it comes to getting a break in Bollywood, I don't think it's very easy. It looks easy, ki acha ek gana aaya and singer hit ho gaya. तो बहुत ही फेमस हो गया एक गाने की देर थी बट वो एक गाने तक वो कैसे पहुंचा हाउ डिड दैट सिंगर रीच टिल दैट वन सॉन्ग दैट इंटायर जर्नी वो कोई नहीं देखता सो दैट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट my first song in a movie came when I was 14 or 15 years old. But how did I reach that position or reach that state when I got to sing for a film? It was a long journey. I started when I was 5 years old. I kept learning, and it's always, you know, joining dots and how you meet different people and how you make an opportunity work for you, and how you excel at that particular opportunity. It all depends on that. So it's not easy, but yes, your hard work pays a lot. If you're really good, I don't think anybody could say no to you. And thoda bahut luck also matters, but it's mostly hard work and talent.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm sure all of our students are motivated by your hard work.
Thank you.
Ma'am, you've previously been mentored by Ustad Fateh Ali Khan. A student from GIIS Pune would like to know how it was being taught by a legend like him.
Rahat Fateh Ali Khan Saab is a legend, and he was my mentor in the reality show I did called Junoon. And I thought he's such a great singer and such a big legend. So I don't know how he would be in person, but the day I met him on the sets of Junoon, he was such a humble guy and such a humble person and very polite when he spoke. When you hear him, he sings like a great singer. But when he talks, he's so polite and he's so soft spoken. So I couldn't believe that Rahat Fateh Ali Khan is here sitting right next to me. So yes, I learned a lot of humility from that man, and he used to give tips that, you know, just close your eyes, just sing from your heart. And he used to ask me, what are you singing today? And then he used to guide me with about the song. So it was a great experience meeting Rahat Fateh Ali Khan Saab.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, our last question for this session is from a student at the GIIS Balestier campus here in Singapore. You have recorded your first album, Romantica, at the age of just 14. You have also recorded your first song as a playback singer at the age of 14 as well. Please tell us more about about your first break and what it takes to achieve your dreams.
Well, it takes a lot to achieve your dreams. And it's not just one person. It's a lot of people behind that person. In my case, it has always been my family, and now my husband and his family. Everybody is supporting me. So if I was alone and I wanted to shift to Bombay and my parents were not, you know, encouraging me, then maybe I wouldn't have been able to go to Mumbai and become a singer. So it's always your parents, your teachers who push you to do better. My first album came in 2001. It released in 2003. I won a reality show called MTV Video Gaga Contest. So it was not just singing. They wanted to check if I dance also well, and I'm singing and I'm impromptu. So as a prize, I got an album. Album deal with HMV, and the album was called Romantica. So that was my first album. And soon after that album released, I got a call for a movie song, for an audition. They wanted to try my voice first. So I went in for the audition, and I was really small, and they were really impressed by my voice, and they said, will you be able to pull off this song? I said, okay, I'll try. So they switched off all the lights so that I'm not conscious that people are watching me in the studio. But I was very confident. And you know, when you're young, you're not worried about what people will think about you and how you're looking and how you sound, what happens if this doesn't go through. You don't worry so much because you're a kid. So you should always maintain that even if you grow. So at that time, I was like fearless. I said, I'll just do my best. And that's what I did. And the song got selected. So that was my first song called Sajna Mai Hari for a film called Aapko Pehle Bhi Kahin Dekha Hai. So yes, that was my first break. And I was in Delhi only when I sang that song. But we were not in a hurry. We said, okay, let's finish my 12th. Then I'll go to Mumbai. Then I'll do my college. And then I'll start with the music. So the studies were always a priority. So yes, it's not just one person. It's a whole team behind an artist. And today I'm here because of my My family, my teachers, my friends have always encouraged me to do better.
Ma'am, I think what you said is really true. Support is essential. The people around you, they really need to be supportive. And also, I'm sure that the audience would like to know, when can we expect a new album from you?
Well, nowadays, the times have changed. Earlier, we used to cut albums. An album used to have 8 songs or 6 songs or 10 songs. But now, the times have changed. And this is the phase of singles. And tomorrow, I'm releasing a single. It's a spiritual single. It's called Satnam Vaheguruji. Tomorrow also happens to be the Gurpurab of Guru Nanak Devji. So I'm releasing it on that occasion. It's a beautiful chant that sometimes when you're alone and you want to meditate. So this is what I sing when I just want to clear my mind and think about the Almighty and be grateful to Him for everything I have. So this is a beautiful musical chant of Satnam Vaheguruji, which is releasing tomorrow. And I plan to release a lot of singles in the coming months, the coming years, on my own YouTube channel. Please subscribe.
Ma'am, we are all looking eagerly forward to your next song and hope to see another hit. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. How many of you are coming to the concert tomorrow? Tonight. That's why you didn't raise your hands. Otherwise, everybody's coming, right? Okay. Kis kis ke mummy papa aa rahe hain? Okay. We have a few people. That's awesome. Any more questions?
Yes. Ma'am, I'm sure we can expect a large audience for your show tonight.
I think it's almost sold out, right, Shweta? So thank you, Singapore, for all your love that the concert is going sold out, and we need your wishes for a great concert.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for coming. We thank you for your inspirational responses. I'm sure all of our students here and those watching online have found your advice useful, especially those wishing to follow in your footsteps career-wise.
Thank you.
To conclude our session, some of our students in the audience have been eagerly waiting to ask you their questions. I
sure.
request you to please proceed to the podium to address them.
Okay.
Ma'am, my name's Jaydev and I'm from GIIS Ballastier. Are you an avid cat lover? Is it true and why?
I am a dog lover. Not that I hate cats, but I love dogs more. And nobody knows, but I was once bitten by a cat. Can you imagine that? And I had to take 7 injections for that. So I love dogs.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
My name is Pranav Goyal, and I'm from Queenstown campus. Kachra Hatao, Rasta Banao was a remarkable initiative taken by the people of Andheri at the Infinity Mall. You also tweeted that the great steps taken by residents, where it was a really great achievement by the residents. So do you have any further comments on this?
Actually, it's always good to use your position for something nice to happen. So when you're in a position when, you know, your tweet or your opinion matters, you should make the most of it. So I feel as a musician or as a celebrity, it's your responsibility to talk about the general things happening in life or about your society. You should always promote it. So this was something happening around my area and I felt it needed to reach more people, so I tweeted about it. And also once you become famous and popular, people want to listen to you and they want to hear what you're trying to say. So you should always promote good things.
Thank you,
ma'am. That was one of them.
Thank you.
Hello, ma'am. My name is Srishti. I'm a really big fan of yours.
You can come forward. Don't worry.
I'm a really big fan of yours. I love your songs. I just love your voice also.
Thank you.
So my question for you is, you have sung so many songs so far. Which one was your personal favorite where you had a really enjoyable experience?
There's so many songs that are my favorite.
Two or three? Any?
I can't choose one. You want me to choose one or tell five?
Any two or three would be
two
good.
Or three.
Yeah.
I enjoyed singing Katya Karu because that was not an easy song, but it had a lot of drama, a lot of singing, and a lot of acting in the song also. So I really enjoyed that song, recording for A.R. Rahman, sir. And then there was Kabira. You know who recorded me for Kabira? Any guesses? It's Pritam Das music, Pritam Chakraborty, but Arijit Singh was recording me on the mic. And it's a duet with him. So I had a great time recording that song. And recently, I loved singing Zalima, again for Pritam Da.
Yes, ma'am, we also love those songs. And actually, my friends and I, we have prepared something for you. It's just a message to you in which your song names are embedded into the quotes which we are telling you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's just a message.
How is that message you're going to?
No, it's written here.
Okay.
Or if you like, I could even read it out for you.
You want me to read it out?
Yes.
उफ मैडम जी आपके गाने में हमारे दिल में दिया जला दिया. यू हैव टू काउंट हाउ मेनी सॉन्ग्स. ओके, आई विल आस्क कि कितने गाने थे मेरे. उफ मैडम जी आपके गाने ने हमारे दिल में दिया जला दिया. आपके गाने की सुर ने हमारे आंखों की हीर उड़ा दी. आई डोंट नो इफ इट मेक्स सेंस बट आपके गाने सुनकर हमारे मन ने कहा चल नच देने सारे और सबने कर दी कमरिया ट्विस्ट. आई कैन हियर यू काउंटिंग, नो चीटिंग. कैसी हमारी खुदगर्जी कि हम आपके गानों के दीवाने हो गए. योर डाई हार्ट फैंस रोशनी सेन सृष्टि रामकृष्णन एंड पुरजित भाई. थैंक यू. सो हाउ मेनी सॉन्ग्स करेक्ट आंसर. Thank you so much. We have more questions?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Hi.
My name is Shruti and I'm from the Queenstown campus. My question to you today is, what was your most challenging song you have ever sung in your singing industry?
Most challenging song? Wow, I don't... Do you remember any? First one, because it was the longest. It was 8 minute 14 second long. And I was only like 15 and I didn't know the meaning of the song. It was a song about heartbreak and the boy was leaving the girl on the day of a wedding. So just to imagine all those things was very difficult for me. But I sang anyways. So that was kind of challenging for me.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you, dear.
More questions? The teachers don't want to ask any question. I think I've answered a lot of questions. But you can connect to me on Facebook and Twitter. I'll be happy to answer your questions there. Thank you so much.